Welcome to lesson number two. We are going to talk about leverage and margin. So before we move on, make sure that you go through lesson number one. You got to know the basics before you learn all these things that I'm going to teach you about today. So if you don't know what I do, I basically speak to people on stage. I speak to people on the stage. And in the past few years, I've been on newspapers, and on TV, on radio as well, and overseas TV channels as well as magazines, interviews, and I've been ranked number one in Singapore Nationwide Trading Contest representing my university. I also studied finance in university, so that is my financial background. And also, this is for my supporters because they voted me for this last year, so I really want to thank you for that. Okay, without you, we won't be able to get this award. Alright, so before we move on, just make sure that trading is not for everybody because it involves high risk and you need to be able to have the proper knowledge before you get into that. So basically, what is leverage? Different people have different terms for it. Some people call it as borrowing money to trade. Some people call this as trading on margin. Basically, when you're trading with leverage, you have the ability to control a large sum of money with a small sum of money. Basically, if you start with a $100 account today, $100 account, and let's say you use a leverage of 1:10, right? So with leverage of 1:10, you can control up to $1,000 worth of currency. You don't have to deposit $1,000 with leverage. This is what leverage gives you, okay? So that's why it allows you to start with a small capital. So the higher the leverage, the more money you can control. And forex brokers normally offer higher leverage ratios. As compared to stockbrokers, you realize that a lot of times forex brokers, they tend to offer higher leverage. So it's a good and bad thing. It's a double-edged sword because you can make a lot of money, but you can also lose a lot of money. So it's like driving a sports car, right? You can get to your destination faster, except for when you're in Singapore, because it doesn't make a difference. There's a lot of traffic light. But I'm talking about if you drive on a highway with a Lamborghini, you can get to your destination faster as compared to a car that is not a sports car. You have a higher risk of crashing a car as compared to a normal car. So basically, what is a margin? So a margin is a security deposit. So it's kind of like a good faith deposit. Now this is very different from a down payment for a house, because when you put on a down payment for a house, you actually own the house eventually. But if you put a security deposit or a collateral, you don't really own the currency. It's just a way for the broker to ensure that you are going to meet your obligations, that you have funds to cover your losses. Okay, so this is just a deposit to give the broker confidence. So in other words, a margin is the minimum sum of cash you are required to set aside to open a position and keep it open. So you need to make sure that the amount of funds you have exceed the margin required. So the margin required would depend on a lot of things. And one of the things it depends on is the liquidity. Okay, the liquidity. So you realize that sometimes the major pairs, they would have lower margin requirements because the major pairs, they are more liquid as compared to the minor pairs and also the exotic pairs. And sometimes once in a while, you realize that when there's a major crisis like 2008 financial crisis and the crisis that we are facing right now, you realize that the margins would actually increase, just like how the spread would increase during a high impact event. And you need to understand one thing, okay, is that unlike stock trading, forex trading margin is not borrowed money. Okay, so next, what is a margin call? Now this is something that you don't want to receive. Basically, this is a warning from your broker to add more funds because you are losing too much money. It used to be a lot of brokers, they would implement margin calls where they send you an email or they send you SMS or give you a call. But then nowadays, because forex markets are so volatile, some brokers, they don't implement margin call systems anymore. So what they do is that when your capital falls to a certain value, that is too low, they are going to close your positions automatically. So basically, a margin call is where your brokers is telling you, okay, we are going to cut all your losses soon, so you better top up more money. And some brokers, they will give you 2 to 5 days for you to find the capital to top up your account. And after that, if you still don't top up your account, they are going to close all your losing positions. And you are going to have a big, big loss. The thing is, a lot of people think that margin call is a bad thing, but actually, it is a good thing in a way. Because it helps protect your accounts from further losses. Because if you think about this, if there's no margin call, and if the broker doesn't cut your losses, it's possible for you to lose more than you deposit. So how do you prevent an MC from happening? First thing first, this is really important. This is what a lot of retail traders, they don't really care because they're just here to make money, right? Like everybody's just talking about making money. What can you buy with that money? And not a lot of people are talking about risk management. I realize that only the ones who know what they're talking about, they will emphasize a lot on risk management. Those clowns and jokers, they wouldn't talk about risk management because you know what? Flexing is their priority. So if you want to become a successful trader, you need to learn risk management properly. There are a lot of components when it comes to risk management. The first one is how to calculate your lot size properly. There are a lot of lot size calculators out there that you can use, that you can install. Percentage risk per trade, also need to know this, decide which one is right for you, how to set your stop loss, right? And also, how many open positions can you have at one point in time so that your risk exposure is not way too much. And make sure you also have sufficient capital. And a lot of retail traders, they like to start with small accounts. Now, if you start with small accounts, it's fine. It's for you to practice. But if you think that this can make you big money, the only place where that is true is in the Get Rich Quick Gurus trading channels. The thing is, you need sufficient capital. The first thing is to sustain the volatility of the forex markets, okay? So that you can have a good level of stop loss that is not too tight. And also along the way, you're going to get consecutive losses, which is pretty normal. So it's normal to have 4 losing streaks, 5 losing streaks is normal. So you need to have the capital also to sustain the losses, okay? Trading an account size that is too small, you also wouldn't take it that seriously as compared to if you are to trade with a larger account. And number 3, never let your losses run. Have the discipline to cut loss. Now, if you think about human nature, how human nature operates is that you are born with the natural tendency to take profits early and also cut losses late. So that's why you need to have the discipline to turn that around. Cut your losses fast and let your profits run. So this means that in trading, you need to have this thing called a soft TP target, but you need to have a hard and fixed stop loss. My stop loss is at this level and that's that. But my TP, I can drag it up as the price moves my way. And this is so that you can capture the trend and let the profits run. And this is so that your TP is always higher or wider than your stop loss. So that when you make money, you make more. And then when you lose less. So as a general rule, you need to make sure that as a start, your risk per trade should not be more than 3%. And also, to prevent yourself from getting a margin call, you need to understand that, okay, if the price hits my stop loss right now, in monetary terms, what is the amount of money will I lose? If you don't have any idea as to how much money you lose when the price hits the stop loss, then you need to learn how to calculate lot size. And like I said just now, every time when you open many different positions, you need to understand what is the maximum amount of positions you can have open at one point in time. And most importantly, what is an appropriate stop loss level? Because you don't want to get a margin call and have your broker put you out of the trade and only to have the price go to the direction you want. Of course, once in a while, if that happens, it's normal, but if it happens all the time, then you need to maybe tweak your stop loss strategy a little bit. Okay, so what's the relationship between leverage and margin? So basically, the higher the leverage or the lower the margin requirement, the more the movement in 1% of the price is going to cause you to experience a large profit or a large loss. So the higher leverage you use, the more money you make, and also the more losses you incur if the price doesn't go your way. Now in the forex market, it's very common to see brokers offering margin requirement of 1-5% or a leverage of 1:20 to 1:100. Some brokers even offer 1:400. This doesn't mean that you should use a high leverage, because professional traders, they generally recommend you to use a leverage of 1:10 or less, because you don't need that high of a leverage to make good money from the forex market, especially if you have a good sum of capital. The reason why a lot of traders, they go and use big leverage, is because they trade with a really small account, like a $100 account. So the thing is, if you don't have the money to trade forex, try not to get into it until you have a minimum of $1,000. Because if you trade with a two-figure account, three-figure account to make some extra income, it doesn't really make sense. And I know that on YouTube, there are a lot of people who tell you you can turn $100 to $10,000 within 1 week. Those people, I can tell, they don't last long. And second thing is that they probably don't know much about risk management. And the worst thing is, the dumb money go and listen to them, and they blow their accounts, they learn it the hard way, then they come here and then be like, "Karen, I should have listened to you." If you want to hear or listen to nice things like you can grow small account to big account within a short period of time, go and listen to them. Okay, go and listen to them. So you realize that the formula for leverage and margin goes something like this. 1 divided by leverage, that equals to your margin. Okay, let's say today you decide to use a leverage of 1:50. Okay, so your margin required would be 1 divided by 50 equal to 2%. So what does it mean by a leverage of 1:50? It means that if you deposit, let's say, $100 and you use a leverage of 1:50, this means that you can control up to $5,000 worth of currency. Okay, you just take 50 times 100. This means that you don't need to deposit $5,000 to control $5,000. You can just use leverage to sort of get $5,000 or trade with $5,000. So I give you one example, okay? How much money will you earn with a leverage of 1:10? Let's say you have an account size of $10,000 and you are trading with one standard lot, and you are trading euro dollar today. If the price moves up by 100 pips, how much money will you earn using a leverage of 1:10? I'm not going to go through the formula in this video, okay? So if you need to go through the formulas, make sure you check the lot size calculation video and value per pip video. So first thing first, because we are trading with euro dollar, it is 4 decimal places. You take 0.0001 times one standard lot, which is equivalent to 100,000 units, divided by the price, which is right now 1.17562, which would give you, in euro terms, 8.51 euro per pip. So you need to change this into USD. So the way to change this to USD, you take euro 851 times your current price, which is 1.17562, which gives you about $10 per pip. And if you pay attention in secondary school, you would have realized that if you put these two equations together, cut this and cut this, 0.0001 times 100,000, then you get $10 per pip. That's the shortcut. So right now that is $10 per pip. So if the price moves up by 100 pips in your direction, the amount of money you earn will be equal to 100 pips times $10 per pip, and the amount you earn is $1,000 if the price moves up by 100 pips. So if you're trading with a leverage of 1:100 and you set aside a margin deposit of $100, so again you take 0.001 for decimal places times 10,000, alright, divide by 1.17433, and then later on you times back the current price. Alright, so in a way you don't really have to go through this process like I showed you just now, because you need to convert back to USD. Your value per pip is $1 per pip. So if the price later on goes up to, let's say, 1.18433, how much money will you earn? 100 pips times $1 per pip, you will earn $100 in profit. So your account will become $200. So this is a 100% gain. But then the downside is that if the price moves down instead by 100 pips, just by 100 pips, you have a negative 100% loss, which means that the moment the price moves down by 100 pips, you will blow your whole entire account, which is not very significant, only $100. So this is the danger of putting in a small capital, because you need to use a high leverage to earn so-called good money. And in fact, good money right now is only $100. This is why a lot of retail traders, they don't last long, because they like to do this kind of thing, because they saw some video online where some dude with no finance background turned $100 to $1,000 within one day. Okay, so how will losing 5% affect your whole entire account? With different types of leverage levels. So the first example is you have zero leverage, second one is 1:5, and then the third one is 1:10. Let's say you waste 1% in every trade, okay, and you have a $10,000 account. When you have a zero leverage account and you lose 1%, your remaining balance would be 9,900. But if you use a leverage of 1:5, your remaining balance would be 9,800. And if you use a leverage of 1:10, your remaining balance would be 9,000. You win more, but you also lose more with high leverage. And if you have a leverage of 1:5, your remaining balance would be 8,100. And 1:10, you would have about 6,500 left. So to recover back to break even when you have a zero leverage account, you would need about 4.1% of ROI to make it back to break even. And then if you have a leverage of 1:5, you would need to generate an ROI of about 22.8% to make it back to break even. And how about your 1:10 leverage account? You will need to make about 52.4% ROI to make it back to $10,000. So normally a lot of traders, they would set a maximum drawdown of 30%, because anything more than 30%, it will be hard to recover back to break even. Like 52% ROI, like how long does it take for you to generate that kind of ROI without taking massive amount of risk? But if you have zero leverage, you only need 4.1%, which is not that hard. Maybe 1 month or a couple of weeks, you can generate that ROI back. So that's the good thing about having low leverage. Okay, the question is, what leverage should you use? This is what a lot of people ask me. What leverage should I use? First factor depends on your experience. The higher the experience you have, then of course the higher the leverage that you can use. And the second factor, risk appetite. Again, the higher the risk appetite you have, then the higher the leverage you can afford to use. Third one depends on the broker. Some brokers offer high leverage, some brokers offer lower leverage, and also depends on the country in which the broker is regulated at, because different countries have different leverage requirements. Some set a maximum leverage of 1:50, some have a maximum leverage of only 1:20. So it depends on the country as well. And fourth thing, depends on the time frame. The higher the time frame you go, then the lower leverage you can use. This means that if you trade with smaller time frames, then you need to use a higher leverage. Next thing depends on your goals. If you want to reach a certain income level faster, then you can use a higher leverage. Next thing depends on your account size. If your account size is just like $100, then of course you would need a higher leverage to be able to earn good money. The larger the account size, the lower the leverage that you should use. But if you ask most professional traders, should you use like super high leverage all the way up to 1:100? Don't need to. They would recommend you, please use a leverage of 1:10 or less than that. Some even specify 1:8 or less than that. So a lot of retail traders, they make mistakes when it comes to leverage and margin specifically. The first mistake that a lot of people make is they don't bother to learn about risk management, like I said just now. They don't even bother to learn about leverage, margin, and also all the other things that I talked about just now. You think about this, the loser traders, they lose because they don't care about risk management, that's why they lose. If you want to become a successful trader, then you need to be able to learn the things that all the other dumb money, dumb traders are not willing to do. Because if you're watching this channel, chances are you're a smart trader, you want to become a successful trader. Second mistake, they employ high leverage to gamble. Now some traders, they even go to the extent of going to many different brokers to shop for the highest leverage. Let's say they see a broker maximum only offers 1:10. Then they go around and shop. It's like leverage shopping. Then they see another broker, okay, offer 1:50, not high enough, then they go and pick a broker which offers 1:400. Like, they just pick the broker based on, okay, who offers me the highest leverage. And the reason why they do this is because they don't know that in this industry, there is massive conflict of interest. Brokers offer you high leverage not because they want to help you make money. It's because they want to entice you to open an account so that you would trade large lot sizes, so that they would earn more money in terms of spread. Because if they offer you higher leverage, you trade bigger size, and hence they will earn more money. You see the conflict of interest there? They just want you to blow your accounts fast, because they know that 95% of traders lose money. Another mistake is a lot of traders, some of them don't have a lot of money, then they get into trading. Like, if you don't have money, don't get into trading. Because if you don't have money and you only have this small amount, you start with a small account, and then you feel that the profits you earn are not enough, then you go and over leverage, right? And a lot of brokers, they know that retail traders like to listen to this kind of messages. You can start with small account and use high leverage to make good money from the forex market. So a lot of brokers, they use this tagline as a marketing gimmick to entice you to trade and then lose money. When your account is too small, the problem is that you cannot set a stop loss that is really, really wide, because you only have so much to risk. And when your stop loss is always very tight, you wouldn't be able to give room for the market to breathe. So you realize that when your stop loss is too tight, a lot of times the price will go down and hit your stop loss before it goes back up and then hit your TP target. The reason you need to have a good account size is because you need to take into account of the drawdowns. You need to give breathing space for the markets. So you need to understand the margin requirements before you open your forex account or stock trading account. And also the fourth mistake that a lot of people make is they pick the wrong leverage because they don't bother to learn about risk management and how it affects their account. And also they don't check the minimum margin requirements that is set by the broker. And the next thing is they don't go and read about the broker's liquidation policies, because different brokers have different liquidation policies. If you have many different open positions right now, they are going to liquidate the position that has the highest amount of loss. Some brokers have this kind of policy. They are going to close your largest positions first before they close the smaller ones. So some of the brokers, they would close you out before you reach a negative balance. And like I said, having the broker close your positions is not necessarily a bad thing, because if they don't close it for you, you might get into negative balance, which is not going to turn out so well. So this is the lesson 2 of the Forex trading course, which I'm doing as part of the COVID-19 pandemic to give back, because I'm inspired by other people who give selflessly during this pandemic. So that's why I'm doing this for you. So I'll launch lesson 3 soon if the response is overall okay. But if you haven't went through lesson 1, I'll put it up in the screen above, and also the lot size calculation video if you haven't went through that as well. I hope that this helps you a little bit to understand leverage and margin. And with that, I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye.